Voyager 1 is doing something insane. What happened to it? What's the difference in its behavior? Why is it behaving like this? We are going to find out everything here. Voyager 1 is sending insane videos. Let us find out the whole truth behind all these points. So stick with the video and watch it till the end to know everything about it. Before that, subscribe to our channel if you haven't, and hit the bell icon to get the notification of our latest videos. On board one of the most important spacecraft that NASA built in the 20th century, a weird thing has begun to take place. Voyager 1 is a proven veteran of space travel. It will soon have clocked up a half century of flying time, yet it is showing no signs of slowing down. However, it is transmitting an unexpected message back to NASA, and they are frantically trying to figure out why this is happening. Erroneous number sequences are being sent by the computer that is responsible for keeping the antenna on Voyager 1 oriented in the direction of Earth. These sequences include rows upon rows of zeros. Members of the mission team, such as project manager Suzanne Dodd, who began working on the Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft 38 years ago as her first job after graduating from college in 1984, are attempting to determine what is occurring on this faraway probe. Dodd began working on the Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft as her first job after graduating from college. At this very moment, the Voyager 1 spacecraft is traveling across the emptiness between the stars. Back in 2012, it traveled across the heliopause, the region of space that marks the boundary between the solar wind's domain and the rest of space. Despite this, the spacecraft is not yet outside of the solar system since it is still under the sun's gravitational grip. As Voyager 1 travels closer and closer to the boundary of our cosmic home, scientists are keeping their fingers crossed that the spacecraft will eventually leave our cosmic backyard behind and go even farther into the cosmos. However, the more distance it travels, the older it will eventually get. Since ancient times, it has been hurtling through space at a rate that is almost equivalent to traveling 3.6 times the distance between the Earth and the Sun every single year. As a result, it is now a staggering 14.5 billion miles away from the planet Earth. Voyager 1 was launched into space on September 5, 1977, 2 weeks after its robotic twin Voyager 2, which had the same mission. Initially, they moved in the same path to meet up with the planets in the outer solar system. But when they swung by Saturn in 1980 and 1981, they diverged onto divergent trajectories and began traveling in opposite directions. Is it aliens? Dodd is asked by Inverse, who does so primarily in jest and with the intention of getting it over with as quickly as possible. After a little pause for laughter, she responds, "No, I don't think so." She explains that it's something in the wiring when asked what the problem is. Which, when you think about it, the circuitry is 45 years old. It's astonishing that it's operating at all, the speaker said. According to Dodd, the investigation is able to determine whether anything is wrong when something is wrong. As Voyager 1 travels across the border of our cosmic lake, which is the region where the magnetic field of the Sun interacts with the interstellar medium in ways that have not been completely figured out, a number of possible occurrences might take place. This backcountry is brimming with astronomical data that has not yet been mined for its usefulness. It would seem that the issue is being caused by the computer that is part of the attitude articulation and control system aboard Voyager 1. This computer, which is one of three on the spacecraft, is in charge of Voyager 1's orientation. This includes controlling the thrusters of the spacecraft and ensuring that the high-gain antenna is pointed in the direction of Earth, so that information regarding the interstellar medium can continue to be transmitted. The fact that the crew is able to guide the spacecraft, in addition to the robustness of the signal and the absence of any activation of the fault prevention system, indicates that Voyager 1 is in good health. Dodd claims that the telemetry signal itself does not make any sense, since it generates either the number 377 or a string of zeros. She explains that if the spacecraft were in a critical state, we would be witnessing a deterioration in our signal from our spacecraft. However, the team is not seeing any such change in the signal. Somewhere in the interaction with the flight data system, there's something that's causing the telemetry data to be jumbled up, I think, or incomprehensible, adds Dodd. And it is something that we still don't fully comprehend, she said. Therefore, the aging equipment aboard Voyager 1 has to be capable of maintaining itself. Dodd made the following observation on the present circumstance. It has a lot of capacity to autonomously recognize what's wrong and place itself in a safe setting, Dodd stated. However, it hasn't gone into any type of fault protection, which tells us that the spacecraft feels that everything is running okay. While continuing to chuckle, she continues by saying, It's simply that for some reason it started speaking a bizarre language which none of us knows. According to Dodd, the next step of the process of identifying the problem will be separated into two distinct stages when it reaches that point. The first thing that you need to do is investigate the root cause of the issue that resulted in the uncommon occurrence and find out what it is. She continues by saying, if we can do that, then we can select what we want to do going forward, whether we want to reset anything or if we want to switch to some of the backup gear. If we are able to do this, then we will be able to make this decision. She states that, then we can determine what we want to do going ahead, if it is something that we can do, because even after 45 years, these systems still have redundancy built into them, and this will not change anytime soon, because... The fact that the amount of time involved is measured in decades, on the other hand, is working against them. According to Dodd, the people who thought of the circuitry of Voyager 1 and sketched out its design are most likely no longer alive or have moved away after the project was finished. This is because Dodd states that it has been over 30 years since the project was finished. There is a very strong chance that we won't be able to figure out what caused this strange incident to take place. In the event that this does place, we are going to continue with extreme caution as we take measures to go back to our normal business operations. She also offers an alternative explanation, which is that it is likely that we may never be able to overcome these telemetry challenges. However, after then, it is just a matter of modifying one's lifestyle to accept the new reality, which may be confusing but is not destructive. After that, it is only a question of adjusting one's lifestyle to suit the new reality. Dodd argues that the fact that they don't know what the abnormality is only made things more difficult overall. You need to be more calculated in your actions going forward in order to ensure that you do not do anything too risky that might put the spaceship in jeopardy, the instructor said. Nevertheless, there is one truth that cannot be denied, and that is the fact that Voyager 1 is continually delivering scientific data on a regular basis, and there are no signs that this procedure will be stopped at any time in the near future. Dodd's response to the question was, first and foremost, it is without a doubt that we will continue to operate the spacecraft, which brought up the subject of his subsequent comments. Here we are done with our video. If you liked the video, then like it and share it with your friends. Let us know in the comment box. Also, if you want to watch more videos like this, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get a notification of our latest videos. Thanks for watching!